going to select this much as the first element, this is the second element, and this is my third element. So whatever element you are going to pick is going to give the directions from there. The next one is cumulative dimensions. So for this one, I just, for clarity, I'll just delete these things. So cumulative, select your first element, second element, and so on. Just delete it again, just doing one more time. Select your first element, second element, third element. So here you can see, like, it's always start from the initial point here. So from that only it starts its measurement. So as I said earlier, I'll just delete it. No need to always go here to measure even radius or dia. You can do it from the first option itself. So I'll just show you how it works. Select this one. I'm going to measure the angle between the vertical and horizontal lines. Select this one and select the second part. Sometimes it will be like in distance. It will be defaultly, it will be showing distance. If you want angle, just right click, create angle. So it will create angle as well here. So no need to go here and check the angle. You can do it from the first option itself. And you need to give some from radius values. I'll just go back to my workbench. I'll create some radius value here. Activate the workbench. Give some radius value here. And go to your drawing. So whenever you do modifications, you can see, like, from the sheet it's asking for the update. So even when you hide or show any parts in the 3D, even when you create a single point, even you didn't even save the, in this case I didn't even save the assembly as well, but still it's going to ask the update. So from the tree, so this is the area we targeted. So if you want, you can directly select this view, right click, and update the selection. So you can see, like, radius value came here. And if you want to update the entire sheet, you can do it from here, right click, update selection, or you can do it from the bottom. So it's going to update all the views. If you don't want it, even in some case you may not require to update the views, because in some cases after you're updating the parts, the dimension may get broken. So if you don't want that situation to happen, just right click, you can just lock the views, go to properties, go to view. You can see the option lock view. Just check on it and just give OK. So you can see there is a lock symbol, and you can observe, like, that it's not asking for updates again. So that's where it will be useful to lock the views and update the remaining views. You can just do it now. So now the pop-up tells, like, the current action didn't take any locked views into account. That's how it works. So whenever you just want to update it, just again go back, unlock it, and you can update it one more time before saving it. So for activate this view, just double click from the tree, and so no need to go radius value. As I said, I can just do it from here itself. Select any radius, right click, you can see the radius tangent, just give OK. So here you can select your radius value here. If you don't want in this style, you can directly go here, select your radius values here, just right click. And when you select the value here, so again these many things get highlighted here. So these are nothing but going to dress up with this dimensions. Select here. So this is the option called orientation for the dimension line. So this is the first option we have. Second is this one. So the style gets changed here. And third one and the fourth one. So for the fourth one, we'll just go back to create a new dimension here. So we'll see how it works. I'm just selecting the two lines. Just give output. You can just move it like this. And you can see, like, I'm going to give third option. So this is how it's going to show. And the fourth option is going to be like this. So it depends on how you want to create a drawing. Select. Delete it. I'm creating a fresh dimension here. Like this. And these many shapes are available in the predefined nodes. So these symbols, you can do it from here, insert symbol. In some cases you want to insert symbol along with the dimensions. So just right click properties. So in future you can just go for graphic value here, tolerance, dimension lines. So dimension text is nothing but your original dimension text. Here in associated text you can see, so the same symbol applies here, this one and this one. You can do it from here or even from here you can do it. So most of the times you will be adding in FCS, feature control frames, you will be adding like this. So main value is nothing but this one, and if you want to add anything at the top you can do it from here, like four places I'm doing, and even at the bottom I can type anything here, or even at the front I can do anything. I'm going to type two times, just give okay. So this is how it works. 19.95 is nothing but your main value. So from the main value you can add any additional information to be provided in the drawing. It can be covered from here, just right click properties. So that's how the font and everything works. Font and everything you can change it from here. And if you don't want the values you can just strike through like this. You can see the strike through. And if you want to overline you can just do it. Overline. Just give OK. I'm deleting it. I'm creating a new dimension here. And after selecting the dimension you can see the font values here. You can change it here. And your size you can do it from here like this, and the next one is the bold one. So there's a difference between this one and this value, and you can just do italic like this. Second one is line, underline, or you want the line at the bottom or overline, and this one is strike through. Do it from here. If you don't want, just select this one and unselect all the things. So the next option is the this one. So where you're going to add any superscript or subscript. So for example, I'll just add text here like A, B. Just give OK. In some cases, you